Hi, in this video we are going to go over the solution of the problem counting number of nodes in a linked list or the length of a linked list. So imagine that I have a linked list here. So it's like this A, B, C, D, E. And as you know, we call the first node here A as head, and the last node that E is pointing is not. And they could have different values. For example, A has a value of 10, B 12, and so forth. And the intention is to find how many nodes we have. For example, for this example, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So number of nodes in this linked list is 5. And first of all, this is the way that we can define a linked list in Python. So that is the class of a node. So by default, the next is none. So and we have to assign the value that we call the data here to the node. And imagine that I define these nodes here, so node A to E, and each one has its own value. And then I have to show that how these nodes are related to each other. So for example, node A dot X is node B. So it means that node A is pointing to node B, and so far for the rest of them. And after I define those things, I have a linked list like this Python that I have the head of that and go to the E, and at the end it's not. And we are going to count the number of nodes. So for example, if I call the first node head as a current here, and so current.next will be B. So if I go forward one step, so B, if B is right now current and C is next. And if I go forward until the end, so at what one point when the current is at the end of the node, so current.next will be none. So that is the whole idea of solving this problem, which is very easy. So I will go one by one over each node and count how many times I'm going forward, and until the time the current.next is none, which shows that my current is at the end, at the final node. So let's do that. So this is the function that we have. So for the counting nodes. So input to that is the head. And if it is head is none, we just return this head is none. That's just a simple thing. So then we initialize our counting value that we are going to count over each step that we go forward. We just put it as one. And then we said that we put the current as the head at the beginning. So current is head at the beginning. And we go in a loop as far as the current next is not now. So it's going to be one by one. And every time we go forward, so the current equals current.next. So because when I go forward, so then this is going to be the current. Then this is going to be the current. So the current next will be the current. And we just add one to the count, and we just return the count. So it's very easy. So let's run that and we can see the result. So initially here, count is one. And then one step we go forward, it's going to be increased to 2, 3, 4, and 5. And every time that we have that here, we can see the current next, for example, at the beginning, current next was 12, and the current updated to the current next value, which is 12, and so far for the rest of them. For example, for we are here, so the current next is 8, and the one that is going to be assigned to the current is going to be 8 by this line. Okay, so this is pretty much the solution of this problem. And the other point is about the complexities, and the time complexity is order of n, because we are going to go over all of the nodes one by one. So it's going to be the length of the linked list, and the space complexity remains one. So this is the solution of this simple problem. And thank you so much for watching this video.